Hello friends, Jasper from Grab Digital here. Today I want to share with you exactly how to set up web tracking on your Klaviyo account in order to capture those customers who have been browsing through your store. So first, go onto your Klaviyo account and in the top right hand corner, go ahead and click that drop down to click on Setup Web Tracking. Now once you're here, you should arrive on a page that gives you the instructions on how exactly to do this, but I'm going to show you the video tutorial of how to do this. So go ahead and click this code, or right click and copy, or Control C, or Command C if you're on a Mac. Then navigate on over to your Shopify store, and click on the left side, you should see a online store tab, and it should automatically take you to themes when you click on it. And you should arrive at this page. For privacy issues, I'm not going to be clicking through everything. So go ahead and click Actions and Edit Code. Now, it took a while for me to load, but once you click on this edit code, it should bring you to a page with all the different pages that you can edit the code manually. Now, either click on the Search Files tab or scroll down and look for the product.liquid page right here. Now, it should bring you to a page that looks just like this. Click Now Enter a few rows below and paste that code that you had copied earlier. Now, once you're finished with this, then go ahead and click Save, and you can navigate on over back to this page here. Now, just for the sake of testing it, this is one of my other clients. I'm not going to show the name of it, but let's just use another client that I already have set up. So it's called rogueindustries.com. We have this text filled out already for that client. So go ahead and click Next, and it should take you to a link. When you click on that link, it should take you directly to the website, all good and done, and then it should say data received. Now if it doesn't, then please go back and make sure that you have this properly copied and pasted and you're in the right folder. If not, Klaviyo does have alternate forms that you can browse, and also they have tech support or customer service support that they can help you with. But if you data received, then you can go ahead and click continue here. Now, in order to track whether this actually does work and you'd want to see it for yourself, go ahead on over to your primary Klaviyo account. So for example, this one, this is under dashboard on the left side, and then click on activity feed. And you're gonna look for one called viewed product. So for your browse abandonment series, in order to see who has viewed your product, this might be empty for you. I have blurred out all these names because these are people, real people, their email addresses from this website. But for your sake, this might be empty if you're setting this up for the first time. So in order to see who has viewed your product, if it already said it says data received, it's all set up, then go on over to your actual website and click on a product or two, and I can't do that here, but go to your own website and click on, you know, just a product or two, browse around for a minute, and then go back to this page on Klaviyo and refresh. And very shortly, you should be able to see that your name should pop up here. Now, one thing I should note is that this sometimes only captures the names with the emails. So if you are not a subscriber, or you have never entered your email into the Klaviyo system before, it may not capture you here. But for the most part, it should capture several people who have been on your website, and over time, this should start populating. And for your actual browse abandonment series, just make sure you link it up to the trigger filter, which is that people who have people who have viewed a product will enter this flow. And one more thing that's important to note is that if you're selling to the EU, you should abide by the regulations in the European Union, in that you don't send any random subscribers or non-subscribers emails or unsolicited emails from your website. So basically, if you are capturing these users that are on your website and they're in the EU, if they're not subscribers, make sure you do not send them the email. Omit them from the flow. Otherwise, you can get penalized for this. And make sure you're only sending to non-EU subscribers with these browse abandonment emails. So I hope this video was helpful, and go off and capture those users.